There's sometimes need for changing somebody's password in a quick and easy way, or perhaps just like right from the command line here. And of course, you could just do password, P-A-S-S-W-D, and then the user's name, and then it'll prompt you to type in the new password. That's not great. You can do it that way, but I think it's better to use something like this. We're echoing what we want the new password to be through password, passwd. We're giving it the dash dash stdin flag, which says use standard input to set the password for test user. You hit enter and boom, now they've got a new password. If we look at the Etsy shadow file, you see the hash is now completely different and their password's been changed. Personally, and Scott, you can disagree with me if you want, I don't love that because the password is now in plain text, one on my screen, which isn't that big of a deal, but it's in Root's history. That's not a great place for a password to be saved. If I've done this in a script, that means the script has a plain text password right there in the script. So if you don't like those things, like I don't, then there's another option, which is usermod. There's another flag for usermod that will let you pass in a hash for the password. But of course, that means you need a hash. So there's other tools that'll help you make a hash. Now, this might sound convoluted and extra. However, I did this with Kickstart files. You're building a server in an automated fashion. Maybe you want to set the root password to a certain standard that you know is across the board. Or maybe you're adding an automation user as part of that Kickstart. And you don't want the clear text password stored in that. This is a perfect use case because you can generate the hash and put it into the script. If someone gets your script, sure, they're going to know that that hash is everywhere, but they're not going to know what the hash is. They're not going to know what that actually reverses to. So there's two tools for that. One of them is a tool you have to install. It's called mkpasswd. And it'll go interactively. So if I wanted to do, well, what was it? Some password I used before. And then it'll just give you, here's the hash for some password. Now you might notice that the hash is different. That's probably because it used a different salt. I think those are generated on the fly. Mkpasswd has flags you can pass in that says what salt to use and all that stuff if you have standards that you need to follow. The other one is OpenSSL, which is a tool that might already be on your system because that's a pretty standard tool. It might even be included in the RHEL base. But OpenSSL, you do password, P-A-S-S-W-D. That tells OpenSSL to invoke that algorithm. Then dash six tells it what version of the hash to use. You do that, it's an interactive thing. But it'll ask me to verify it. As long as I type them both right, we have a hash. Now, what do we do with the hash? We take that hash we made, it's copied to my clipboard. If I do usermod dash p, which tells it to set the password. And if you look at the man page, it says to use a crypted password, not plain text. I like to put them in quotes just because it does have a dollar sign in that hash, if you notice, and bash will sometimes say that's a variable and try to read that variable from the system's environment. If we paste that in, close the single quotes, and then tell it user, test user, it should set that exact hash inside of Etsy password or Etsy shadow. There we go. Notice the quotes aren't there now, so no copy and paste fail this time.
Here's why I like echoing the password. Mkpasswd is a great utility, and it can, one of the other things it can do is make random passwords. So it'll make like a 8-character password with a mix of case and numbers and okay. But if you're resetting somebody's password, you have to tell them what the password is. Otherwise, how do they know how to log in?
That's why I'm saying if you use OpenSSL or mkpasswd and give it a password, you can give that to the user.
Yes, but you have to remember it because you didn't, you typed it in, but it's not stored anywhere. If you're doing things like scripting, you could do something like call mkpasswd, which makes the password, then send that to a mail command where it'll like stick it in, but it will end up being passed around plain text, but you're also trying to distribute it to the user in plain text. It all kind of works out. I get not wanting to have it locally in your possession so that somebody could compromise the root account and then start knowing all these other user accounts. Although I would also argue that if they compromise the user account or the root account, you probably have bigger problems.
This is probably true. There are valid use cases for both scenarios, which is why I showed you both. I'd love to hear in the chat, folks, tell us which one you prefer. Do you like passing in a clear text password or do you like using a hash like I did? I think I know what the answer is. We'll see.
We should just write it on a sticky note and put it under our keyboard.
Yeah, that's probably the way to go.